Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy iPod King Carter here. Today's video is going to be some My Part gameplay 3v3 on a sunset court. Now, this was early in your boy's career. I was barely a noob, a little fish in a pond. Here, I was just getting my feet wet with everything, trying out the servers, stressing everything, trying to get people to come to the park, trying to get people to come to my court a lot. I was trying out Pro-Am. But today, we're here to actually talk about what 2K has lacked in, man. I know a lot of people have been waiting on this video. They've been like coming to my channel like, bro, you usually one for the community. You usually speak out against the nonsense that's going on. And in this video, I will, because 2K literally told me that they were coming with a patch and they didn't have all the patch notes listed for me. They wouldn't divulge all the information, but they did say that a patch was coming. So now that the patch is out, I want to talk to you guys about it, because I feel like nothing has changed on PS4, not one little thing. Now, 2K did put out a patch on both consoles. They put it out on Xbox and they put it out on PS4. But what they did stress was that a lot of Xbox users were losing their characters, and that this patch was really hopefully try to negate that. Now, me personally, I do not have Xbox. I did not feel anything. I did not get that wave, that big tsunami. I didn't get any of that, man. I was on PS4 running all weekend, having fun, playing games, but I was steadily getting tweets like, hey man, I lost my character. I spent over, 190,000 VC. Man, I lost my character. I spent 40,000 VC. Man, I lost my character. I dropped $200 on PSN cards. I'm like, bruh, like, where is all this coming from? But nobody would send me proof. Nobody on Twitter would say, oh, here goes proof of my mod player before it got deleted. Here goes the save file now. It's not there. Check out the cloud save. It's not there. Like, nobody sent me any info. So I really thought that it was trolling. I thought that people were just coming to my streams, coming to my videos, like, just trolling me, because you know, that's what some people do sometimes. But when I found out that it was a real problem in the community, I did reach out to the necessary people and ask, hey, what are you guys gonna do? What's gonna happen? And when they told me, it was kinda too late to make a video because the patch was dropping literally like probably 36 hours later. And when they told me this, I was like, oh, okay, cool. I hope everybody's gonna be happy with that. But the main problem is, now that patch one is out, there's no patch notes out. I've looked on Operation Sports. They've said that they're waiting on the patch notes themselves. I've went on to 2K's regular page. I went to developers' pages, and nobody has the patch notes. Usually when a patch happens, everybody knows what's going down with this patch. Now, for right now, we don't know what's going on. But all that I can say is that I'm pretty pissed off, because there are top five things that I cannot stand in 2K18. Number one, why can I not hit a layup? That is the biggest question on everybody's like top of the list, bro. And every patch was listed that I've seen on Twitter, videos people have made, they've been trying to figure out why people can't hit open layups, lightly contested layups, under the basket layups. And I'm talking about people with high layup ratings. I'm not talking, look guys, you just seen it. That was a shooting foul, but he clearly had the lane and he couldn't hit that layup, man. Like, I don't know what is going on with 2K, but this whole layup debacle problem, whatever, is crazy. Now, the second thing that I have a problem with, I have a couple Dunkin' bars. I've went to the shoot around before the game, and I've been doing windmills. I've been doing Zach LaVine packages. I've been doing all of this pregame. But as soon as I hit the court for my career, or I come over to my park, or I go to the Pro-Am, I can't dunk to save my life. I can't get out of a sticky situation with a crossover and come down the lane and think that it's my paint, because it ain't my paint. My layup is either going to get blocked. I'm either going to have to be a little bit of acrobatic and get a layup off that way. I cannot dunk. Now, there are two instances where you do dunk. When you're out on a fast break and you let go of turbo, if you hold turbo once you get to the foul line, there is a possibility that you will dunk on a fast break. Also, if you're cutting to the basket, but you're not holding turbo, like if you press turbo one time, like tap it just to get that momentum cut into the basket, and then whoever passes you the ball on the dom, then you have to press R2 again before you press square or whatever analog to do a special dunk, and you just might dunk. But all other instances, you will not dunk unless you're a slasher. Now, they put out on Twitter, Zach Timmerman put out, you know, who can do posterizers and stuff like that. I believe they need to put something out who can dunk, man, because this is a major problem in 2K18, man. A lot of people are pissed off. A lot of people, man. Now, the next thing that I don't understand, I went into the NBA store. I went into the swag store. I went into Foot Locker. I purchased all these different items to wear in Pro-Am. I'm a Pro-Am player. I play casual Pro-Am. I'm not a professional Pro-Am player, a competitive gamer. No, I'm not that. I play casually. So when I come in, I knew from last year that you could put accessories on, but that's not the case for 2K18. When you go to my court to change your clothing, you can change nothing in Pro-Am. Once you get into the Pro-Am arena, you cannot change anything in a Pro-Am arena. There is not a locker room in the Pro-Am arena for you to change your clothes at. Not at all. There's no option on your phone. There's no option in nav. How in the world did we get here? How did we get to a point where we can't wear any accessories, 2K? This is just something that the community has been wondering about. This is not a rant video. This is not a rage video. This is an informative video because maybe some people missed it. Maybe some people just didn't understand that, oh, maybe I just got to go somewhere and equip it. But every time they go into a Pro-Am game, they don't even worry about accessories until they figure out, all right, I'm gonna spend my hard-earned VC on this. I'm going to go ahead and go to Pro-Am, put this gear on. You go to your mock court, and it's not available to put on in Pro-Am. It's ridiculous. Next thing. Why in the world am I paying for a haircut every single time I go in a barbershop? I understand the cutscenes, I understand the nostalgia of it, but I'm tired of spending my VC whenever I want to change my beard, bro. I mean, I know I'm not spending no money on haircuts because I'm the baldy god, but as far as beards, I should not be spending a bunch of different VC. I feel like if I want all these beards, I should be able to just pay for them all at one time. Like just bam, 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 select all and purchase. So I could just swap them out. Maybe I could just pay the barber and just put everything on my tab for the rest of my life. You know what I'm saying? Why not, man? Why can't I do that? Now, next thing, Nike endorsement. I had got the Nike endorsement video. That video will be dropping in about another hour, guys. But in that video, I got the endorsement. The team said, hey, I'm going to hook you up. And probably like a day in 2K time where I was playing a game and stuff like that, they told me that I wasn't wearing Nikes anymore. I purchased a pair of Kobe's, which are Nikes, and they took my endorsement away from me. They literally said that I wasn't wearing Nike gear inside the games and that I was actually wearing a different brand, and they took my darn sponsorship endorsement or whatever you want to call it away. It doesn't make any sense. Is it because I was wearing Jordans at the My Park maybe? Like, I don't know, because I noticed that some other endorsements pay you for park and for the league. So I don't know, man. 2K, it just doesn't make any sense. Why should a person park and league tie into their endorsement? I thought that was all my career. It just doesn't make too much sense to me, man. And I believe that I have another problem too. It's when you're going into a loading screen for your emotes and stuff like that. Now, I just believe that when you're going through your moves and stuff like that, you have to go to nav, then you have to go down to signature, like inside the My Player Lab. And when you come out, you have to then equip everything after you purchase it inside of another window. And then you have to come out and see if it worked. Like, that's just too many menu jumping, man. I mean, you did make it easier for us not have to go to my court to my park, and then from my park to my court and all that stuff like that. But why are we now jumping through hoops and menus to equip different things, to equip different shots, equip dunking and all that? It's so many goddamn menus, man. It's a purchase menu, then it's an equip menu, and then this is a funny thing. When you purchase something, you can't put it on right there, or you can't come out of the purchase window and go straight to your signature signature emotes, your signature dribbles and stuff like that, and equip the moves that you purchased just like they had in last year's game. I mean, if you guys have any problems with NBA 2K18, please list them below. This is IKC signing out. I holla. Chase Money.